The wait is finally over. Hey, what's up guys, it's TECHOSAUR. So Hades 2 is here, and while it's still in early access, I've still picked it up and wanted to try it out on the Ally. Performance-wise, it works like a charm, but I wanted to experiment a bit and share some easy tweaks you can apply to boost its performance at extremely low TDP, because at 10 watts, it easily runs at 120 FPS on high settings in 1080p. But at lower TDPs than 10 watts, performance is quite reduced. I wanted to make this small video to show you some ways you can boost Hades 2 performance if you are limited to use lower than 10W TDP. So that will be the target of this video, and there will be also some findings that I would like you to know, so let's dive right in. In Armory Crate, I limit my power limit to the lowest possible. For Sustained Power Limit, or SPL for short, it will be at 7W. But in Armory Crate, we can't limit the boosting power limit to 7W as well, so it may sometimes go higher than 7W. So we're going to use the Ryzen utility tool to limit our wattage to the lowest value possible there. Also, I would like to point that Hades 2 is mostly CPU dependent and barely use any GPU. So to make sure that most of our allocated power goes directly to the CPU, for that I limit the GPU clock to the lowest possible, which is 200 MHz. And still, as you can see, even with this low GPU clock, GPU usage is around 81%, so it means we are not being bottlenecked by GPU, at least at this low TDP. In game settings, I have high graphic preset and 1080p. Now I want to show you that when I limit the TDP to 8W, you can see that in a standstill scene, FPS is around 86, which is actually pretty decent. At 9W instead, it jumps immediately over 100 FPS, since the CPU is clocked at 1400 MHz. So you can see that this game is heavily depending on the CPU. Now as soon as I set it to 10W, we'll see FPS matches the Ally maximum screen 120Hz, making our tweak kinda meaningless in such a case. Naturally, the first thing we'll need to confirm is making sure we have selected the right GPU VRAM option. So for that, I'm going to test out all options starting with auto and ending with AG. Let's get to it. And we see that no matter what we choose, it barely makes a change. But as you can see, 4G and 8G are neck to neck. Still, 8G is actually better for a very odd reason. When I set it at 8G, it's using only 2500 MB of VRAM. And the same case even for 7G. As strange as it sounds, when we set it above 6G, rather than taking 4350 MB like the previous setup, it somehow reverted VRAM usage to 2500 MB with both 7G and 8G. It's such an odd behavior, but still tell us that this game barely needs VRAM, like even 1G is giving decent performance. But still, if we set it to auto, it will use only 400 MB, and that's actually giving us the worst performance out of all, quite significantly too. As for the rest of other selections, it's all good. So we can conclude that auto option is definitely not good to use on Hades 2. You can go from 1G up to 8G just fine. And for me personally, since I usually daily drive at 4G, so I'll be keeping it in this way. Now the next tweak is tightening the memory timings by using smokeless USB bootable BIOS. For those that follow this channel for some time, you may have seen my memory timing tweak for the Ally and the Legion Go as well. And in case you haven't, you can check out my full step-by-step guide about how to tighten memory timings on your hardware. I'm still using those timings ever since I made that guide, and it's all going fine. So no issues whatsoever and no risk at all. And it gets even better the higher the CPU frequency you have. In case you have any question or struggle of setting it up, feel free to drop a comment, or I can gladly help troubleshooting at the TECHOSAUR Discord server. So anyway, I'll show you the results before and after. At 8W, our average improved by 2 FPS. While I know that 2 FPS is not a big deal, this tweak will help at all times. No matter what you throw at it, it will always get higher performance. And switching to 9W TDP, here we also see a minimal improvement. Again, I'm not saying it's significant improvement, but still it's improving some FPS and frame time as well. It's a free tweak, and after trying it for some months, I can say it's quite safe and works even with the latest BIOS versions, making it quite straightforward. But we are not done here. The next thing I'll try is disabling global C state. Again, by using smokeless tool, by going from AMD CBS to CPU common options and just disabling the C states option. Now for those that don't know, C states are like lower power states that the CPU goes into when it's idle. But due to poor optimization, sometimes CPU randomly enters C state even while executing tasks, especially at lower frequency, and this will introduce some lower performance and input lag. Here you can see the improvement of after disabling C-state. It clearly improved average FPS further than when it was on by 2 FPS after tweaking memory timings from before. Finally, another setting I tried, which is the CPU virtualization. Of course, for a handheld, you will not need it for most of time, so you can disable it directly in the Ally BIOS menu. And as you can see, with SVM on, it significantly lowers performance. With it off, we improved all three of average, low 1% and 0.1%. So in conclusion, to show you the difference from where we started, at 8W we got around 3 FPS average improvement and significantly improved our loss as well as at 9W. So that's all about it. I just wanted to share with you guys some easy to apply tweaks in case you were restrained by a very low power budget. While it's minimal, I still hope you found this video somehow useful, and in case you did, please give it a like and subscribe to TECHOSAUR. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.